Hello and welcome to another video from the MicroRooster. Today's topic is the command manager basics. We're going to introduce you to some of the capabilities of the command manager. This is an administrator tool. We could view it from the MicroStrategy products itself if we want to run the interactive version or the wizard. Just connect to your project source, use your metadata and use your password. And now you're into creating your scripts. Your first script would be the untitled one. You could have opened the existing script. You could save your scripts as well. And you could save them wherever you want to reuse them later. So I have one that was saved, has some of the functions that I wanted to talk to you about today. You have execute procedure type of functions. These are procedures that were saved and they're reusable. So if I execute this one where it recursively lists all users of type developer, of group developer, it's showing me that I have one user called developer. Now this is a procedure, so it has to use the execute procedure command. Where do I get this, or where can you get this? If you go and look into the outlines, let's go first and look at the procedures. You could create obviously your own procedures, but these are outlined for you, kind of samples. So I'm going to expand them here and show you the list. There's a list of examples of procedures that are used, and usually they're just referencing the most common ones. It'll give you a description of what it is and how to use it with a sample. You can insert the sample or you can copy and paste it, whichever way you prefer. And let's close this box, or after we copy it and use it, which is the same one that I just created earlier. But this one I'm going to put in all users. Of the group developers. All right, so that's how I created my first procedure. There's other things like creating users, creating facts. You can look at the list, it's an endless list. But now, let's say you want to create scripts or you want to see scripts other than procedures. So what is a procedure? It's a custom set of scripts, for instance. But you can create, use simple scripts or complex scripts from the outline as well. And you can bundle a bunch of them up into one procedure. So this is, for example, looking at the attribute creation, deleting, altering attributes, etc. There's a lot of components that you can put into this, a lot of pieces of information that you can add. Most of them are optional. So let's take a look at another procedure. Look at the execute procedure, and we want it to, for example, list filters for a certain project in a certain folder. By executing it with no dependence, it's still running. So this is a very handy one when you want to do some cleaning up of your system. And again, this is just an example. Let's see if it returns anything from our tutorial. So it brought back two filters that it says are not being used. So if you're doing some cleaning up, you might want to flag those two for deletion. Okay. So if you use backslash, it turns green, and that way it's not an active script or procedure. Now let's look at something else. We can also use the command manager for creating user groups or folders. We can also create events. We can list all events before we create the events. For instance, see all the events that are available in our project. And we can create our own events as well after we view what's available. There's a bunch of commands that you can use. So if you start typing like list space and you start typing something, you will see other commands or other keywords that you can use. Keywords are going to be labeled in blue. Unidentifiable words will remain black. So that's how we come up with this script. Now I'm creating an event. And I copied this from the outline. I just wanted to show it to you. So I'm going to create an event called My Daily Report, execute. And now I have a new event called My Daily Report. And then if I want, I can trigger it. So a triggering of an event would be a useful thing, a useful script to use or trigger from based on a Windows schedule, for instance, at a server. For instance, if that's what you're trying to get to. You can also control jobs, so you can purge all caching, which is very useful. You could also create and publish cubes. So instead of going into the developer app, you can actually just activate, publish. You can deactivate, update, delete any cube. Also a very useful thing is updating the schema and refreshing the project, so you can do that as well from a script. You can restart server, stop, you can list tables, and you can again execute procedures all from within the script editor. Let's look at the procedures. Let's see, after you finish your script or your set of scripts that you want to add into one procedure, you can bundle them up together and save your script in a procedure. So procedure editor, and you can paste your scripts here. And you'd have to give some more identification information to your let's see. We're going to go to the outlines folder and we're going to select from the, let's look at the procedure outlines and the samples, and here's the complex and long script that was used to create a fact. So the procedure create fact has a lot of about 30 or 40 lines of script built into it. So that's how you build complex procedures if you want to. Obviously, if you notice, the blue text is simply script keywords that we showed in the script editor. I'm going to also run the interactive command manager, which is similar to what we were doing, but this one doesn't have the wizard interface. It's simply a command manager using simple script. So this is a simplified version. So all it is was the command manager dash interactive. And now if I'm going to connect to MSTR to my project as an admin, I type in my password, and once I'm in there, I can start operating. If I don't know the commands, I can use the help to remind me of what is available. So here we'll see all the different activities that we can do. So you can write a script and then execute the script using execute or cancel a script. You can also load files and execute files from the command manager right here. So this is similar to what we did previously, but this is simply using the line command. So here I'm just going to list members for user group managers. I don't know if I have any in the tutorial, but let's see. And then I'm going to execute this. And here we go. We have a bunch of users. So it's going to list them and their login and full name. So again, these are just scripts executed from the command line. So you could just decide to go this route instead of the interface route. And we're going to exit. There's another way to use the command manager, which is directly from the system command. And if you do command manager LT for light dash help, and I'm going to minus N or dash N for connect, and then I'm going to view the different, use help to view the different commands here. What this allows us to do, if you notice these commands, we can connect and we can run or execute. So I'm going to first run it as an administrator. And I'm going to run a file. So I have my demo scripts saved in an SCP file. And now when I run it, the output is going to by default go into the command cmd-mgr text file in my MicroStrategy folder. Thank you very much, and see you again in the next video.